share my screen here. Please let me know. Is my screen is visible to you?
No, sir.
Now see here. I am displaying whiteboard here. Is it visible?
Sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
All right. Thank you. Please mute yourself for some time. Now I am going to solve a problem that is belongs to the earlier classification, that is linear and non-linear systems. Okay. Already we have discussed about the continuous time case. If I have given you a system and you have been asked to verify, okay, you have been asked to verify whether that system is a linear or non-linear system. So for that purpose, that system must obeys the principle of superposition. Okay. Right, see here. Now we are going to see one more problem based on the discrete time case. So check the following system. Following system is here, is it visible? Here I am writing a problem.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Check whether the following system is linear or non-linear. Check whether the following system is non-linear. Okay. Now, that system is given by y of n is equal to x of n plus 2 into x of n plus one by x of 1 by x of n minus 1. Now, this is the system you have been given. So, for this system, we need to verify whether this is a linear or non-linear system. Already, the procedure is exactly similar to that of the procedure what we did for continuous time case. In that continuous time case, we are applying each and individual arbitrary input signals x1 of t and x2 of t. Okay, so by applying those two input signals, we are going to obtain the individual arbitrary outputs y1 of t and y2 of t. Later, we have applied the weighted sum of the input signals x1 of t plus x2 of t. And for that signal, you are going to obtain the response from the system. Okay, that is what we have seen in the earlier case. So in this case also, again, the procedure is exactly similar to that of continuous time case. Here, I am considering x1 of n is x1 of n. Please remember, here the system representation is completely in terms of small n. So by seeing this time index, you can be able to understand the given system is a discrete system. Okay, the given system is a discrete system. Okay, so x1 of n is the input of the system, discrete system, and y1 of n is the output you are getting from the same system by considering or by taking x1 of n. Similarly, x2 of n, comma y2 of n are arbitrary input signal and the output signal of the same system. Okay. Right. Okay. Now we are going to apply each and individual arbitrary signals x1 of n and x2 of n, and we are going to see, we are going to observe the response from the system. So here, if you are applying x1 of n to the system, and you are getting the corresponding output y1 of n. So just you simply substitute that x of n is equal to x1 of n plus 1 by x1 of n minus 1. Now this is equation 1. Similarly, by applying second arbitrary input x2 of n, you will get the corresponding output as y2 of n is equal to 2 into x2 of n. See, there is no difficulty to understand this concept. Simply, I am replacing and I am placing each and individual arbitrary inputs x1 of n and x2 of n. And first of all, you have to obtain the individual responses from the system. Later, we are going to supply the weighted sum of the input signals, and correspondingly, you are going to get the required output signal. Okay. So y2 of n is equal to 2 into x2 of n plus 1 by x2 of n minus 1. Okay. Now this is equation 2. Students, do you have any doubt up to here? Equation 1 and equation 2. Do you understand what I am saying? Simply, we are going to get the individual responses from the system. Okay. Individual responses. That means you are giving individual signals x1 of n and x2 of n separately. Okay. Now we are going to see what is the response from the system if you are supplying weighted sum of the input signals. That means weighted sum means x of n is equal to x1 of n plus x2 of n. This is the weighted sum of the input signals. So y of n is equal to, if you are supplying that weighted sum as an input signal to the system, you will get the weighted output response. So y1 of n plus y2 of n. That means indirectly I am saying that substitute x of n is equal to x1 of n plus x2 of n, y of n is equal to y1 of n plus y2 of n in the given system. So if you substitute these two weighted sum of the input signal and output signal in the given system, obviously you will get, so y1 of n plus y2 of n is equal to 2 into, simply I am replacing x of n with the x1 of n plus x2 of n. Please remember. Okay. So this is 2 into x1 of n plus x2 of n divided by, sorry, plus 1 by, what happens if you substitute, sorry. What happens if we substitute x of n minus 1? So x1 of n minus 1. So here, remember, x1 of n minus 1 plus x2 of n minus 1. Now see, this is equation 3. So to have or to check the condition for linearity, equation 1 plus equation 2 equation 1 plus equation 2, that must be equal to equation 3. So this is the condition for testing the linearity of the system. This is the condition for testing the linearity of the system. Now tell me, 1 plus 2 is equal to 3 or not in this particular problem? Now just add one equation 1 and equation 2. Now what you will get? What you will get? Now see here. So again, I am going to write down here. So if you add this, if you add equation 1 and 2, you will simply get y1 of n plus y2 of n, y1 of n plus y2 of n is equal to 2 into x1 of n plus x2 of n. Now carefully observe this. So what happens, or what is the resultant signal if you are combining equation 1 and equation 2? So here you will get 1 by x1 of n minus 1 plus 1 by x2 of n minus 1. Now this is equation number, this is equation number, or equation 1 plus equation 2 is equal to, this is the resultant signal. Now we will see the left hand side of both the equations. Now see here I have written the combinations of, or the summation of equation 1 and equation 2 with the red letters. Okay, just to see the font. So here I have used a red mark. So now this is the case. Now this is the case. So left hand side you will get y1 of n plus y2 of n. So in this case also you will get y1 of n and y2 of n. So left hand side is matched. And coming to the right hand side part, the first part is 2 into x1 of n plus x2 of n. So in this case also you will have 2 into x1 of n plus x2 of n. That is also matched. Now come to the second part. Now see here. See, in this case, you will have 1 by x1 of n minus 1 plus x2 of n minus 1. But whereas in this particular case, this is 1 by x1 of n minus 1 plus 1 by x2 of n minus 1. So this part is not matched with this part. This part is not matched with this part. So equation 1 plus 2 does not equals to equation 3. That is why the given system is a non-linear system. So in this way, you have to check whether this system is linear or non-linear. I think I am getting a very low manner, okay? Because of your understanding. Is it clear? Do you understand? Do you have any doubts regarding this problem? Or regarding the linear and non-linear classification of the systems? At least any one of you, please put the question or answer in a chat box so that I can able to see how many of you have understand this. Shall I move on to the next one? Okay, thank you. No doubts. Shall I move on to the next one? So with this, we have completed the linear and non-linear systems classification. The linear and non-linear systems classification. And we are also having two more topics left. So out of those two more topics, the first classification is time variant and time invariant systems. This is also very, very important along with the linear and the non-linear systems. Okay. Now we'll see what is time variant and what is time invariant property. So time variant, as I already told you that, okay, time variant, most of the times, just by seeing the title, you can able to understand the concept here. You can able to understand the concept. Time variant, that means the input and output characteristics are varying with respect to time. okay, and time invariant systems, that means whatever may be the time, the input and output characteristics do not change with respect to time. Okay, so most of the times in real time or practical applications, we are using LTI systems. See, all the systems till now we have seen only of LTI system. That means that system satisfies the linearity property and time invariant property. What do you mean by time invariant property? So time invariant, the characteristics of the input and output do not change with respect to time. Suppose if there is a small change in the time of an input signal, again you are going to have the same change in the output signal, then only that signal or system is said to be time invariant system. Suppose if there is a small change in the input signal and the change you have not included in the output, means obviously that is a time. So let us see, okay, by considering a simple example, time variant, the next classification, time variant and time invariant systems. Time variant and time invariant systems. Okay. Now see, the system is said to be time invariant, means system is set only time invariant. Time invariant if the characteristics of input and output do not change with respect to time. Now students, here I am writing the basic classification or the basic definition of time invariant systems. Okay, can you able to see? Now if the given system is said to be time invariant system, the characteristics of the input and output do not change with respect to time. So this is called time invariant system. Suppose if you are assuming that a small change in the time, okay, that may be either continuous or continuous time system or discrete time system. We don't bother about the type of systems, but the procedure is very important. The procedure is also exactly same. Once if you are familiar with the procedure of continuous time case, obviously you can able to apply the same procedure for discrete time case also. But the only difference is the time index. In continuous time, we are using small t's, and in the discrete time, we are using n, small n. Okay, that is the only big difference. Okay, when we come to discrete signals and continuous time signals. Okay, so in this case also, when there is a small change in the input signal or input, suppose that's a small change in the time of input, we will get the same change in the output also. That is only for time invariant. See, I am talking about time invariant systems. Okay, whatever may be the content I am writing here is completely related to time invariant systems. If the system is not a time invariant, means obviously it is a time variant. So time variant means obviously your input and output characteristics are changing with respect to time. That is the concept you have to understand from this, right? Now this is about the time invariant systems. Now let us solve the problems related to the time variant and time invariant systems. Now see, simple. I will solve simple problems for you people to understand the concept in very clear. Okay, we will solve one problem related to continuous time case, and we will solve another problem related to discrete time case. Okay. Now please, all of you, take a look at this content. What I have written here. Is it okay? Shall I move on, or do you have any doubts? You please raise your doubts also. Still, if you are having no doubts, please put the same in the chat box. Students, is it okay? Shall I move on to the problems? Shall I move on to the problems? At least any one of you, please respond. Okay. Thank you. Now, see here. You have been given a system that is y of t is equal to t into x of t. Now, this is the system. This is a system you have been given. Now for this system, okay, you have to test whether this system is a time variant and a time invariant system. Okay, now see the procedure, how I am going to solve this. If x of t, just wait a moment, I shall use another color. So this is the solution. So here I am going to start the solution for the given problem. So here x of t is nothing but input signal. Okay, input signal, and y of t is output. So y of t is the output. See, first of all, you have to assume all these things before going to start your solution. X of t is input and y of t is your output. Now, mathematically, the system can be, mathematical representation of a system is y of t is equal to transformation of x of t. Already we have seen this in the topic of the first classification, that is continuous time systems and discrete time systems. Continuous time systems and discrete time systems. So y of t is equal to t, capital T denotes for the transformation. Capital T denotes for the transformation. So the basic transformation are the basic operation that you are going to perform on the x of t, that is input signal, to get the required output y of t. This is the concept. Okay, don't consider capital T as the fundamental time period. Please do remember. Now see here, suppose if there is a small change in the input signal time period. Now input signal is x of t. If there is, that means x of t has been shifted to a new value of time. That means, see here, the transformation of x of t minus capital T. Now what is this? This t is different. This T stands for the transformation or the basic operation performed on x of t. But this T stands for the time has been shifted by this many units, capital T units. Capital T is units here. Okay. Now, what happens, sir? What is the response you are getting by delaying the input signal? So that is denoted with the y of t, capital T is equal to you are changing only the time period of x of t, but not the completely. Now see here, this is the response obtained by delaying the input signal by t units. Students, please be very careful to understand this particular concept. This is a very, very important, and it is also very easy to understand. Okay, see here how I am going to write down all these things. Initially, I am considering x of t is the input and y of t is output. And as per the mathematical representation of a system, I have written like this: y of t is equal to the transformation of x of t. Now, what type of transformation you have applied here? The time, basic time shifting operation. That means we are only considering the shift in input time. But here, this small t represent, or it t belongs to this response y of t, but not for x of t. Okay, please do remember, this t belongs to y of t, not for x of t. But here we are obtaining the response of this same system by considering some delay in the input signal. So this is equation number one. Now, as per the definition of time variant and time invariant systems, you have to consider the same change in the output also. So whatever may be the change you have taken in your input signal, again, for a time invariant system, the same change may occur in the output also. So for that purpose, I am considering, okay, wait, I will take with, I will represent it with the another color. Now see, now the response y of t comma minus t, that means again we are considering the same delay in the output also. Now you need to substitute t minus capital T multiplied by x of t minus capital T. Simply replace small t by t minus capital T. Why? Because now see here, your system y of t is equal to t into x of t. If you are replacing t with the t minus capital T, means obviously and all the values on the right hand side, so you need to replace t by t minus capital T into x of t minus t. Now this is equation two. Finally, if you want to say that signal is a time invariant system, or that system is a time invariant system, now see here, y of t comma capital T should be equal to y of t minus capital T. That means equation one must be equal to equation two. Then only we can say that system is a time invariant system. If that condition does not holds good, obviously we can say that that is a time variant system. Now see, check whether these two equations are equal or not. Now consider equation one. So you will get a t into x of t minus capital T. That is equal to, now see here, so t minus capital T multiplied by x of t minus capital T. So these two are not equal. That means it is a time variant system. Is it clear? Students, do you understand the difference between time variant and time invariant system? In this particular case, this is a time variant. Why? Because you have not getting the necessary, or you have been not satisfied the necessary and sufficient condition. That is y of t comma capital T is equal to y of t minus capital T. Students, is it clear? At least, can any one of you please respond? So that I can be able to understand you people have understood this concept or not? Shall I move on to the next problem? Shall I move on to the next one? See, it is not okay for me. Okay, when you said okay means obviously I am also okay. Don't say that okay sir. Okay, if you are having any problem, okay, you ask, or otherwise sir there is no problem, you have to write the same thing on the chat box so that I can be able to see here, right? So most of you are saying no doubts means, so obviously I can move on to the next one. See, I'm rubbing. So this is continuous time case. So the given system is a continuous time system. Now we are going to see the same case for discrete time systems. Discrete time systems. Discrete time systems. Right. Now, the discrete time system is also very, very easy. Now, let us see. Y of n is equal to x of n. Y of n is equal to x of n plus n into x of n minus 1. Now this is the problem that what he has given, and you have been asked to verify whether this is a time variant or time invariant system. Okay, now can anyone tell me the answer expected? What do you have expected? Expected answer. What is your answer? Is it a time variant or time invariant? Just by looking at the system, is it possible to say whether that is a time variant or time invariant system? What is time invariant system? If you assume a small change in the time in the input signal, again you are going to get the same change in the output also. Okay, now simply I am directly write down the case here. Initially I am assuming a small change, that is k, in the input signal. In the input signal, that means if I are playing the transformation on this one, I should be able to get this signal x of n minus k here. Now, okay, you do not alter this n. Why? Because this n related to the output, not for the input. But here we are considering only a small change, or the time has been shifted to a new value only for the input signal. Now, see here, n minus k minus 1. Now, if I have chosen, k units has been shifted. Now this is equation 1. Now let us see the next one. Again we are going to consider the same change in the output also. Again the output is also shifted by k units. Okay, so whenever you are finding the small n means, obviously you should substitute small n is equal to n minus k. So if I substitute small n is equal to n minus k in the given system, obviously I should be able to get x of n minus k plus n minus k. Now here n relates to the output, so that is why I am substituting n minus k instead of n. So now x of n minus k minus 1, this is equation 2. Now please verify whether y of n minus k is equal to y of n comma k. This is the response obtained. Y of n comma k is the response obtained, okay, by considering a change in the input signal. And y of n minus k is nothing but the response obtained if you are considering the same change in the output also. Now in this particular case, is equation 1 is equal to 2? No. Why? Because this term is completely different from equation 1. So these two terms are not equal, means obviously that system is a time variant system. time variant system. So this is the best example for time variant systems. Okay, time invariant systems are also there. Obviously, in that particular case, y of t comma capital T in continuous time case, y of t comma capital T should be equal to y of t minus capital T for time invariant systems. In this particular case, that means for a discrete signal, obviously for a time invariant systems, these two y of n comma k should be equal to y of n minus k. Is it okay? Is it okay for you? Okay. Now let us move on to the next one. CR, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Is my voice is audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now consider the last classification. Consider the last classification, that is stable and unstable systems. Okay, so with this we shall conclude the today's session. Okay, the next one is stable and unstable systems. Stable and unstable systems. Okay, now this is the case. Now when we are going to say a particular system is a stable and when we are going to say a particular system is a unstable, this is also very, very important. I think you people have very much familiar with these words, stable and unstable systems. Why? Because already control systems has been completed in your earlier semester, right? In that particularly the fourth chapter, stability, the concepts of stability, what you have studied are completely related to these systems. You are going to say whether a particular system is a stable or unstable systems. Okay. Now, at least any one of you, please tell me how to determine the stability of a given system. Use your knowledge, what you have gained in the earlier semesters. I think these topics have been covered in your control systems, stable and unstable systems. There, we are going to draw the pole zero plot. Just by seeing the pole zero plot and by the location of poles, we can be able to say whether that system is a stable or unstable systems. That means on the S-plane, if the poles are lies on the left half of the S-plane, obviously that system is a stable. If the poles lies on the right hand side of the S-plane, obviously that system is a unstable system. And if the poles lies on the imaginary axis, means obviously that system is a marginally or critically stable system. So this is, poles are located with the cross mark. Okay, this is LHS, left hand side of S-plane. So this is how, I think this is how you are going to determine the stability till now, right? This is S-plane. If the poles are located on the left-hand side part, system is stable. If the poles are located on the right-hand side part, system is unstable. If the poles are on imaginary axis, system is critically or marginally stable systems. But the actual definition of stability is, there are so many definitions are existing. Now see here. When you call a particular system is a stable system, that must be a given system is said to be stable if and only if for a bounded value of input signal, the output must also be bounded. Okay. For a bounded value, Bibo stability. This is Bibo stability. If the input is bounded, means output must be bounded for these stable systems, then only we can say that system is a stable systems, or otherwise that system is unstable systems. Bounded input and bounded output. Okay, or you can also define the stability by considering this S-plane. Okay, if you are considering S-plane, if the poles are located on left hand side, you can say system is stable. poles are located on the right hand side part, you can say the system is unstable systems. The poles are located on the imaginary axis. You can also say that this is oscillatory or critically or marginally stable systems. Okay, this is how you are going to classify the systems. So with this, we have concluded today's session. Now I am giving you 5 minutes time for clarifying your doubts. Okay, let us discuss about the doubts, what we have covered so far.